So, as you know, this session is about online tools for entrepreneurs. These are some tools which I have personally experienced in my 6 years of entrepreneurship. It's not a long one, but it was a good one because there were a lot of new tools coming up which I could utilize in my business. So, professionally, I'm a founder of PagePotato.com, which is the way I make money. I make websites, digital marketing, animation, ERP implementation, and basic IT setups for middle-sized companies. And my passion project is Learn and Teach Anything for Free, through which we are doing this. So let's start. First, because Google is such a big thing, I have put everything of Google in one slide, and then we'll have more things, more softwares. But Google, if you are thinking of entrepreneurship, you should really make friends with Google. Google has a lot of tools which you should really have, and they are very important tools which I think should be very costly if you count the worth of them. But then it's very nice to have them and know about them. First of all, Gmail, of course, Gmail. Every one of you might be using Gmail. Later on in the slides, we will see that what there are small things which are missing in Gmail, which you can also include in your Gmail list. We'll see that. But of course, you should use Gmail. The important thing of Gmail is, even if you are making a company ID, for example, tim@abc.com, you can sync that email ID with your Gmail. So what happens is, Gmail is very good. The UI interface is very good of Gmail. So you can sync your company email ID with Gmail as well. There is a process. The process I have included in the last slide, you will see there is a video. This is the Page Potato playlist on YouTube, and I've included all the videos of how to do it in that playlist. So you can check everything which is there in these slides on that playlist. So Gmail, you should actually sync your Gmail with your company ID. Google Drive. Google Drive gives you the ability to work even when you are moving, so mobile. Basically, whenever you are working on your laptop as well, always store your documents or Excel sheets or anything in Google Drive folder. What it will do is, it will directly throw things on cloud. On cloud means basically on internet. So you can just log in, you can just plug internet in your laptop, and then you can just access your files. It also helps you to collaborate with people, like two people sitting in different countries, you can still collaborate on same folder. And this is helping me because my whole team sits in India, and everything is managed on Google Drive and Dropbox as well. Google Calendar, this I'm pretty sure in Netherlands everyone is using that because Netherlands is a country of calendars. So sync your calendars with Google. It is damn good. Even if I'm booking a movie and the mail comes that I have a movie tomorrow, somehow Google knows it and it'll sync it to your Google Calendar, and in maybe 1 hour or 2 hour before the movie, it will say, hey, you have to reach the movie hall. So it's fabulous. And you can make your own events as well, like just one liner that I have to be here at this time, and Google Calendar will be synced. And all these Google products are responsive. Responsive means they are for mobile as well as laptop as well. So Google, just activate Google Calendar on your Android or iPhone, and then it'll start showing you pop-ups that you have to reach there and all those things. Google Webmaster. See, whenever you are in an online business, you Google is the big fish of this online ocean, and you have to love the big fish. You cannot be enemy of the big fish. So Google Webmaster, what Google Webmaster does is, if you have a website, then Google Webmaster tells you that what is going on in your website. So and you, when you have a website, you always want that when people come on Google and they search, for example, best photography or best video maker in Netherlands, then you want your website to come up. For that, you should always register with Google Webmaster. And when registration means, just go on Google Webmaster, type your website name, and Google just knows that, okay, this is your website, and it'll tell you all the things about your website, the health of your website. Google Analytics. Google Analytics will tell you what kind of people are coming to your website. These days, you might be seeing a lot of videos that Google knows about you more than you know about yourself. So it knows what kind of searches you are doing, what kind of preferences you are doing, what is your age and everything. In Google Analytics, you will be able to see that what kind of audience are visiting your website. Are they youngsters? Are they people of age 50? Are they women, men? What are their likings? What are their behavioral patterns? Knowing these, you can plan your marketing advertisement expenses, because marketing is a huge expense. If you are having a business of your own, then marketing will be one of your big expenses. And it's always good that you can see, the rule of marketing is 100% of your money will never be successful. In marketing, some percentage of your money will go waste. But the skill is, you should know which is the important percentage. Google helps you do that because it focuses on the behavior of your audience, and accordingly you can put money in that, in your advertisements. Google AdWords, if you say, it's like when you Google search something, you will see there's some organic searches, like the top 10 searches, and then there are some ads, right? Have you seen that? Google shows you ads. That is through Google AdWords. Why is it important? I always give this example. See, in real business, for example, tomorrow you open a shoe shop. How will you market it? Maybe the easiest marketing, the most costless marketing would be knocking each other's doors and just tell that, oh, see, I have opened a shoe shop. But how many will you be able to do? Nothing. What are the other ways? You'll think of, okay, let me put an ad in a newspaper. Let me put a banner on the streets or something. They're all costly. They are very costly. That's why when you start a business in real world, it's a little costly and a little effort taking. It's always easy to start your business online. Google gives you that ability that by paying some amount of money, you can still come in the top list. Just imagine the people who are, if you search good shoes, then who will come? Maybe Adidas or Reebok, these will come. But with Google AdWords, you will also come on the top. Just that you have to pay a little more to Google for per click. If somebody clicks on your ad, then you are charged. But at least you have an opportunity to be in that market of big fishes like Adidas and Reebok. The real world doesn't give you that opportunity. That's why Google World is important. In Google AdWords, keyword tool is an important tool because you will know that what people are searching for your business. For example, if you are a glass manufacturer, then you might be thinking in your mind that, oh, people are searching nice glass for drinking water. But this might not be true. People might be searching something else, shot glasses. Their keywords can be different, right? Their keywords can be very different what you are thinking should be. That's when you have to read the minds of your customer, and that's when Google will help you with the keyword tool. Google will ask you, what is your business? Tell me your website. And Google will analyze your website and will tell you that you are in this business and people are searching this in your product segment. So you'll be more precise in knowing what my customers are searching, and then you can update your web page so that your web page has more chances to come on the top. This is what Google AdWords keyword tool does to you. Google Sheet and Forms, another very good tool under Google's bucket. Google Sheets and Forms. So Google Forms you can use to design your feedback forms, so many things. You can just design your forms by asking your name, your email ID, what do you think, and this and that. And the answers can automatically be updated in your Google Excel sheets, which you can check, and it's as easy as an Excel sheet. So Google has, this is another product of Google Drive, under which there are Google Sheets, Google Forms, Google Docs. They're all sharing platforms. Google wants you to collaborate on these platforms so that two, three people sitting at two, three different locations can still discuss and talk about things. Let's go to the non-Google stuffs now. MailChimp, how many of you have heard this name, MailChimp? Three, cool, four. So MailChimp is basically email marketing in which you can send your contacts, your existing customers, or maybe the email IDs which you collected from your marketing efforts, and send them emails. Now you can ask, okay, sending an email is, I can do it from Gmail as well. I will just put every email ID in BCC and the emails will be sent. So the negative of this is because that doesn't look professional, number one. Second is you won't be able to analyze. In business, whatever you are doing, you should be able to analyze it. If you're not able to analyze it, what will happen is, in business, everything is about money and your time. You will invest money and you will invest your time. So if you do not know where you have to invest your money and time, then you are not doing a successful business. And for knowing that, you have to analyze that. Yesterday I did this, what was the result? On the basis of which you will take today's action and similarly tomorrow's action. So MailChimp gives you that ability to send emails to specific lists. Maybe you can have buckets that this email ID, these are the bucket list of email IDs which are my customers. These are my probable customers. These are my contact list which I got from this event or from that thing. So you can bucket them, send them specific campaigns, specific emails, and then MailChimp will also tell you that how many emails were opened, how many emails were opened for how many number of minutes. So you know that whether did you design a good email or not, or can you improve your email next time or not. So an analysis, MailChimp gives you that analysis. So track actions on your email, design awesome actionable email templates. In the email, you can also have buttons, call to action. These are called call to action buttons in which you can like click on read more, buy now, know more, things like that. This is the website you can go on. This is just a small screenshot which I've shown you. Hootsuite. How many of you have heard of Hootsuite? Cool. So two. So again, a new thing. Hootsuite. What today is the world of social media, right? You cannot exist without social media. Everything you have to put on social media. At least the three big ones are LinkedIn, Twitter, and Facebook. With Hootsuite, what you can do is two biggest ability of Hootsuite. One, post on all the three social medias together. Number one. Number two, schedule them. So it's practically not possible that I sit every day and do the postings on Facebook. You will see that all the time of yours will go on Facebooking and Twittering. What you should do is plan out your 1 month, that 1 month I have to do these many campaigns, and then plan it today. You can schedule on Hootsuite. There's a button here which you can click and you will post your message, then a picture, and then you can select that on which network I need to post them, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Facebook, and then schedule, give it a date and time. You can do it for the whole month or maybe for like I do for 6 months. And then automatically it keeps on posting on my Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn pages. So it saves a lot of my energy. Rule of thumb for business is do one kind of activity at once. If in a day you are doing 16 kind of activities, you will not be efficient. You will be efficient in which in one day you are doing one kind of activity. So dedicate a day in a month in which you are just making these schedulings. Your efficiency will be more. So this was Hootsuite.com. It is also free. Till three accounts, you can do it for free. After that, all the tools I'm telling you, they are free initially, but when you use them more, they will charge you something. But fabulous for entrepreneurs. As entrepreneurs, you should always try not to buy things first day. If you are a person who is buying things on first day, chances of failures are more. Don't increase your cost too much on first day. Biteable. How many of you have heard of Biteable? Cool, something very new. So Biteable is about making videos. Again, today is the world of social media, but video making is costly as well, which Tim right now is helping us with this costly service. So what you can do with Biteable is Biteable has these kind of footages. You know, like this is an animation of book opening. This is an animation of camera clicking. This is like thumbs up for Facebook and all. So Biteable has these kind of animated footages. Then it has real images as well, like a girl jumping, all kind of things which you can analyze, you will need in a business environment, like team meetings or something, and they are all HD footages. And these footages have these kind of spaces to write a quote. So what you can do is, for your business, you can develop this storyline and choose these footages and combine them. So you can very easily make a 1 minute video. I take only 15 minutes to make a 1 minute introductory video to make this. And the best thing is they have all the footages where somewhere you will find the link. It's not 100% customized, but for an entrepreneur, 70% of your job will be done. So you can always tell a storyline about your product or your service or anything. You just need to be a little creative in making a storyline and then combining those footages with the storyline. So this was Biteable. WordPress. Monique knows WordPress, right? Many of you as well. Yeah. WordPress, yeah. So again, online business, you cannot work away from WordPress, and it's really, really nice. I have all my websites on WordPress. It's free, and they are fabulous templates. You don't need a website designer to be true to make your own website if you have a little patience and a little of WordPress skills. Every website can be made on WordPress, and they have fabulous templates. and your websites can be launching like in one day. You can in one day you can launch your website, any website. So WordPress, the best thing is many entrepreneurs feel website is okay with entrepreneurs, but they always ask questions like, hey, come on, if tomorrow I have an event and I want to upload one image, then I have to call you again. Oh, I need this social button, then I have to call you again. So this is why WordPress is good, because WordPress gives you this dashboard, and this is in your control, your business owner's control. It gives you the control over your content. So you can upload any image, you can upload any content, anything. You can just do anything, unless and until it's too customized when you have to change the codes, which will be like only 10% of the times if you are a basic entrepreneur. Rest, everything you can do on your own. So it has pages, you can upload your blogs, you can upload images. There are so many. Then WordPress also gives you this independence of having plugins. What are plugins? Plugins are like, for example, for me to dress up right now, I need maybe two clothings, maybe my underwear and my top shirt. But this is an accessory, like watch is my accessory. If I wear a necklace, it's an accessory. These plugins are your accessories which can beautify and increase your functionality of your WordPress website. Maybe if you want, tomorrow you will say, okay, I need a pop-up. Someone comes on my website, I need a pop-up saying that, sign in on my newsletter. You have seen those kind of pop-ups, right? This can be done with the use of a plugin. You can just include a plugin and your website will have that functionality. There can be so many things. You might have seen in Christmas, you want my website, somebody comes on my website and there are some red hearts or Santa passing by on my website. You can do it by plugin. So these are the cute plugins, but there are some serious plugins as well, which have some serious, there are some anti-malware plugins as well, which will save your website from malware attacks and all those things. So DDoS, iThemes, these are all plugins which can save you from virus attacks. So WordPress, definitely. Quora, I was telling about Quora that day, Monique. What is Quora? Anyone of you have heard? Quora is one platform which is like a question and answer platform. Any type of questions you can ask in Quora, like from the most stupid questions to most intelligent questions. The concept of Quora is you ask a question and then Quora has all kind of profiles. And then Quora will suggest you, for example, if you ask how to work with this camera. So Quora will know that, okay, with camera, these are the experts. Somebody is a camera expert, somebody is a photographer guru or something, and it'll give you a hint that do you want to ask this question to this fellow? So imagine what kind of resource you have. You can ask your basic question to the industry expert. And then that industry expert gets an email that, okay, somebody has asked a question. And that's what Monique, I was telling you that day as well, that these kind of forums should have a natural way of giving you thumbs up. So if suppose I'm the industry expert of photography, then why would I care to answer your question? And anyways, you have asked a stupid question, which is like, I don't have time for that. But if I answer that question, then my Quora profile improves. And when my Quora profile improves, it indirectly helps my business because people know that, oh my God, this fellow is answering fabulously well and people are liking his answers. So automatically there is a thumbs up on my profile and people visit my profile and they say, oh, what he's doing, he's answering nicely. So he must be a serious person and they will go to my website and check things on my website. So Quora, because as an entrepreneur, you will have hundreds of questions. You can have so many questions because in life, there are so many things already available. But trust me, when you are an entrepreneur, you will be brooming your room yourself and you'll be talking to your customers and whatnot. You'll be just doing everything about your business yourself and you'll have so many doubts. How to get this table? Like I need four tables in cheap cost. Who will answer you? Quora will answer you. Go to Quora and ask these questions. So this was about Quora. Again, repeating all these videos are there on the playlist of the link I will show you, and you can check how Quora works and how everything works. Boomerang is something very interesting. As I told you, it's a Gmail add-on. The video will tell you how to include that Boomerang thing in your Gmail. What happens is, Gmail has one missing point. It doesn't give you that reminder. So for example, if ABC sends me an email that, oh, let's meet up day after tomorrow, then what I have to do is either I jump to my calendar now to set up a meeting, or I can use this Boomerang service. What Boomerang does is I will just check the email and then click on this logo, this Boomerang thing here. Where is it? The Boomerang thing comes here. So for example, this has emailed me and then I will click on boomerang, and it'll fix up a meeting that remind me about this email in 1 hour, 2 hour, 4 hour, 2 days or 1 day. So it's a reminder. So in 2 days, if you have put up 2 days, then an automatic email will pop up in your inbox saying that this was the email on which you have to take an action. It's a fabulous thing. I didn't know this for years, and now I've started using it, and it's fabulous. In fact, I have emailed Google that, hey, please include this reminder thing in your email. I need that. And then I saw Boomerang, and it exactly does that thing.
If you use Google Calendar, you can invite someone to a...
to that event, right.
He gets an email too.
Yeah.
He can press on yes, I come.
Yes.
And then automatically it's synced with the Google Calendar.
Very true. So Google Calendar is more about serious events, right? Just imagine you won't make a Google Calendar to remind you of an email. That so many a times you just see an email, oh, he has emailed me, but you know that I can reply him back at night. Rapportive. Has anyone heard about this? No? This is again a Google, this is again a Gmail thing. What it does is somebody sends you an email, and it will automatically tell you in this area her or his LinkedIn profile, Facebook profile, and all those things. And if on the same browser you are using your LinkedIn as well, then just on a click of a button, here see, LinkedIn, Blogger, all her social profiles will come here. If she's using the same email ID with all her social profiles, and just by clicking here, you can get connected with her. So it's really helpful if you're having a business email ID on Gmail, because you can very quickly connect, and you can accordingly respond as well. You can see basic things will be shown to you, and you can accordingly respond to any person. So Rapportive, again, a good Gmail add-on for entrepreneurs. So they do not need to have Rapportive. You need to have Rapportive to extract their information. She doesn't need to have Rapportive at her end. So it's your, because Rapportive, what it does is, it just takes her email ID and tries to search on LinkedIn that which LinkedIn profile is linked with this email ID, and just throws that information to you. Because most of the time I do this. Whenever I receive some email from a professional for anything, I open a new tab and go to my LinkedIn and try to search. It's a hack. It's again 3-4 minutes wastage, you know. You have to search by name, and then you won't be able to find, and all those stuffs. This is fabulous. Multiple Chrome. This is the most useful thing if you are an entrepreneur, because if you are an entrepreneur, of course you have one laptop. You won't have 5 laptops with you, right? You will have personal things to do on your laptop. You will have business things to do in your laptop, right? But do you know that in Chrome, you can make 2-3 multiple Chromes? Or you are still using one Chrome? And then getting confused that, oh, I have to use one Facebook, and then I have to use 2 Facebook. Or maybe your wife also, or your girlfriend also uses your laptop, and then you have to sign out from your Facebook, and then log into her Facebook, and all those things. It happens to you? You can use multiple Chromes. So these are the Chromes which I have. So I have these many. I have 4 of these are business profiles. Then one is for Rishika, one is for me, and then so many other Chromes. And then and every Chrome can store your own password. So maybe one Chrome has Facebook and stored password. Second Chrome has another Facebook and stored passwords. And you can be on 2 Facebook at the same time. You have to use many other services. But you have Firefox, Safari maybe, and then Chrome, and that's it. Then some shitty ones. Yeah. But then Chrome, you can use multiple Chrome browsers. You can open 2 Facebook at the same time with 2 different usernames and passwords. But this will be really useful if you do this. Use bookmarks. How many of you are using bookmarks on your Chrome? That's good. That's really, really nice. I will show, should I or should I not? Again, it'll go. No, it's coming on my laptop, but no. So see, the image. Can you see this image? I've just taken a screenshot of this image. Many a times I've seen that people make bookmarks here. How you can make a bookmark? For example, here you will type facebook.com, and then there's a star button here. Press this star, and the star button will tell you that, okay, this is your bookmark, and which folder you have to, this is important. You can make so many folders in your bookmark, and according to the categories, and each and every Chrome can have separate bookmarks. Just think about it. So your personal things can be, a folder can be bank accounts, my social media profiles. But your professional ones could be my client websites, competitor website, all those things. So you can just, and Goodreads or maybe news or something like that. So these are these folders you can make, and under these folders, when you will type, for example, if I'm doing my, these are my Google Sheet folders. So everything I'm making in Google Sheet, I'm storing in one folder. Similarly, things related to this, things related to marketing, things related to content, social, everything I'm storing in separate folders. The best part is, even if something happens to your laptop, maybe it virus attack or maybe it gets lost or something, then in a new laptop, if you will sign in that Chrome with your email ID, these bookmarks will automatically be sucked in. So this is like working truly on the move. It has happened so many times. Rishika knows it, right? Something happens to my laptop and I'm scared, oh my god, again I do, because that was the time when I stored so many things, but now I lost it and now it's nothing. Laptop, something happens to it, format it, and just again sign into my Chrome and everything is as ready as it was 1 hour before. All my Chromes are there, all my logins are there, everything is there. So you should really be using different Chromes and use bookmarks. Bookmarks will really, really help you. It really makes your work very efficient and well managed. Picto chart. Do you know what are infographics? Again, in this social media world, infographics plays a very important role, in which infographics are things like this you might have seen, where facts are explained in form of icons or vector images or graphics. Then earlier, people used to think that, oh my god, I have to be a graphic designer, I have to do a course in graphic designing, and then I need to know Photoshop and all these tools to make these infographics. Not anymore. PictoChart is one website where you can go. How PictoChart works is, again, it has so many icons and everything related to what you can need, what you will ever need in your business, like a person, there will be so many people icon, receiving service, giving service, happy faces, sad faces, all those things. Enough number of icons that you can make a story. How Bytable was working in form of footages, this website works in the form of giving you separate icons. So you can just pull any, and it'll give you all these things, making a pie chart, graphs, airplane, heart, and all these are available here. Like you can, it'll be enough for your requirements, for you to make a story or something like that. You can show any fact in the form of infographic. Go on PictoChart, and you can make awesome infographics. It'll be really helpful for OWC for sure to explain how things work and whatever. Like for anyone, I guess. Anyone needs an explanation. So PictoChart. Filmora. Again, something related to Tim. These days, videos, if you will see the analysis of social media, they say that 2017 will be the year of videos. Photos, and even today on Facebook, people watch more of videos than pictures. Earlier, the day was people watched pictures more than the text. Now it has come to videos, and that's why people are making 360-degree video. There are so many video formats coming. 360 degrees, and then virtual reality and whatnot, like crazy stuffs of video making. So much so that even this camera is becoming an old thing now, and people are believing on their phones, because phones can do so many things. Hi-fi phones are there, you know, with so much memory and so much of video quality. So Filmora, you should really try downloading Filmora Go. Filmora Go is a software which is a mobile app which you can download. Just pull videos, and you can do crazy stuffs on Filmora Go, like add, just you can do everything what you can do with any software, any Adobe software. So Filmora Go, definitely you should try. If you want to try something on your desktop, then this is another VVideo which I use. So VVideo has awesome video editing tools. We can clip the video, join together, play with the audios and all those things. You can also edit green screen videos, which not many editing websites have. So green screen videos, you might be knowing when you stand in front of a green screen, and then you can delete the green screen from behind and put a fabulous background. So you can make all those. Earlier I was using Windows Movie Maker, but it is the simplest form of video editing. But when you will see, like Filmora can give shades to your video, then add some nice fonts, throw some stars and whatnot. VVideo is a computer one, but you can use it for some time for free, and then you have to pay, but the payment is very cheap. Like for maybe $10 or $15, you can make a video editing of 1 hour. That's a pretty okay one. Then Lucidchart. What is Lucidchart? Lucid chart is another, like picture chart you saw, it was more graphical. But this is like a serious stuff, where you in your companies, you will see you are making flow charts, flow diagrams, especially if you are working in an IT segment where everything is very professional. You cannot use a picture chart thing on a in a professional world. It's more for websites and more for social media. But this is when you actually explain somebody the processes. So you need icons and all those things. You can see the image. It defines what I'm trying to say. So Lucid chart, it's very useful. Earlier, many people used this thing, Visio. Have you heard of Visio? Visio was used, but this is a very advanced version of Visio. So use it if you are making some explanations or explanation of how we work, how the process works, mainly to explain the process. SquireUp, very interesting. This is one of the good ones in real business. So as the image shows, if you are a restaurant owner or something in which you deal in cash, if you have to, not cash, but like a point of sale, if you have a business which has a point of sale, then you can sign in on SquireUp. What they do is they will send you for free this reader. They will send you this card reader for free, which you can fix it on your phone through the earplug. And then your phone becomes a card reader, as good as a card machine. They will also give you this POS. This is called POS, point of sale software. So a POS of a restaurant is something else. A POS of a bookshop can be something else, and so many other things. But this is for free. What they do is whenever you swipe your credit card, if suppose 100 euros have to come in your bank account, then the customer will be charged 100 euros, but you will get maybe 98 euros. So 2 euros will go in their bank in start SquireUp thing because as a service. The same thing what happens with PayPal, how you use PayPal for your websites, in which they charge about 3.9%. They also charge the same thing, but PayPal is all about online. You have to put your card details online, but this is the hardware which they are giving for free. WhatsApp Web, this is it's basically your mobile image on your desktop. So it's not a download, but when you will go on this website, you will be seeing a black and white barcode, and then you have to scan through your mobile, and then everything what happens on your mobile phone will come here. The benefit is sharing of links is easy. Like sharing of a web link is easy here. Then if you have a video on your laptop, then it becomes easy to share through your WhatsApp. Otherwise, what will you do? You will transfer the video to your phone, and then from phone you will upload it, and phone speed is always less. And laptop is, of course, a better device. So I always use WhatsApp. Like now I am so used to WhatsApp Web that even when I can reply someone on phone, I will prefer to come on my laptop and then reply, because typing is easy as well. Here the typing is all thumb. Yeah. Earlier I used to surprise people by replying them so fast, and they will be surprised. How are you replying so fast, man? I'm not able to type, and you are replying like 2-3 messages, and I would never tell them that I'm using WhatsApp Web. Until it has become very popular. Cool? The last one, Slack. Slack is a team management platform. You can imagine, if in the easiest way, Slack is basically your business Facebook. How you collaborate on Facebook, like you have friends, then you can share a few things, you can tag some friend on some message, and all those Facebook thing is what Slack is for your business. So you can make like Travidux Incorporated is your main brand. Under that, you can make channels. Channels are basically your departments in your company. So a marketing department, an account department, a this and that department, whatever department. And you can include specific people to that department. So, and then you can always collaborate. This is the collaboration which you are doing, basically chatting. You can chat to in specific groups how you do in Facebook. Then you can also put specific names of people. And the best thing is Slack is also handshaking with Dropbox and Drive. So Slack is basically a front end, which gives you all the opportunities to talk to specific people. But at the back end, there is Drive and Dropbox, which stores all your file. So everything basically is on cloud. So even when suppose now you're working on Slack and your laptop disappears or something happens to your laptop, what will you do? You will buy a new laptop, sign in your Slack, sign in your Google Drive and Dropbox, and everything is set up again. That's why I always say use Dropbox and Drive, because if this thing is lost, you'll be really scared, your things are lost. But if your things are on Google Drive and Dropbox, But since you're an entrepreneur, trust me, you're not too important a person for anyone to hack your account or something. Unless you become a very big company, then of course you will have your own servers and, you know, you will take care of all those things. But for an entrepreneur, Dropbox and Drive, don't be scared of Google. So these were the 14 awesome tools which I had experienced in my my career till now. This is the, if you can access, better this, note it down or just take a picture of this right now and go to this Bitly. Bitly again, just in air, I will tell you what is. So if you see, a YouTube link was that big. Now I could not, this will be a shitty thing for me to share that big a link. So I use Bitly. Bitly is another software which reduces your URL. So if you have a big URL to share, you can use Bitly to shorten it, and you can also customize it. So I have customized it as Page Potato. You go on this link and you will find all the videos for which I have talked about.